So, the other day at work, I met a colleague of mine who started to talk about how he met his old college professor the other day. Long story short, the professor told him about the internal scandal that went on a few years ago at campus. They were planning to conduct an experiment in which they were supposed to measure something using strong electricity. In order to do the experiment, they needed to buy some really expensive equipment from some foreign manufacturer. They bought the machine and plugged it in. After it booted up, it started to print out some illogical data. The scientists working on the experiment were baffled about the data. It simply didn't make sense whatsoever. Since they just bought the machine, the first thing they did was to call the manufacturer and say hi to his mom and demand a checkup of the machine or a new one. The maintenance squad showed up and started to check the entire thing. They more or less disassembled it and assembled it once again. Having not found any mistakes on the machine, they couldn't do anything and told the scientists that it's their problem now. The scientists were lost, being stuck with a seemingly broken machine. They didn't know what to do except to study the data. They concluded that for some reason radiation is messing up the machine. Having nothing to lose, they took a few Geiger meters and started to scan the campus from top to bottom. The search for the source led them to the main gates where Joe the doorkeeper was.
What you doing there?
Nothing much, we're just testing out some of our toys.
Sure enough, there is the janitor's room right next to the porter's table. They asked Joe to open the door, and indeed there was a few brooms in there, and that's it. The Geiger meter was spinning in circles by now, but they didn't see at first what was causing it. They stepped in and looked around. Then a scientist found a bucket filled with some sand. In the bucket, there was a few cigarette butts. The scientists realized this is the source of the radiation. In the bucket was radioactive iodine, which was most likely a news product from some previous experiment. The cleaning lady cleaned it up and stored it there, since they might need it someday.
Joe, how long is this here?
It was here when I started to work here.
How long have you been working here?
For about 10 years.
Joe, do you smoke?
Yeah, I do.
Do you know that that will cause you cancer?
I'll be fine.
I wouldn't bet on it.
The big mess up was covered up, since they didn't told anybody about it. To make the situation even funnier, the college organized a public lecture on nuclear waste management and disposal just a few weeks earlier before the discovery.